I'm Alex Villarreal with the VOA Special English Health Report. World AIDS Day was December 1st. This year, experts reported more signs of success in halting the AIDS epidemic. The number of AIDS-related deaths and the number of new infections are both decreasing. Michel Sidibe is the executive director of the joint United Nations program known as UNAIDS. He says today, we can say that we have changed the direction of the AIDS pandemic. The latest UNAIDS report says new HIV infections have fallen almost 20% in the last 10 years. And there has been a similar drop in the last 5 years in the number of AIDS-related deaths. An estimated 33 million people worldwide were living with HIV last year. 2.5 million were children. HIV is the virus that causes AIDS. Africa, south of the Sahara, has the most deaths and new infections. But many of those countries have made important progress. Worldwide estimates show that more than 2.5 million people became infected with HIV in 2009. At the same time, about 1,800,000 people died from AIDS-related sicknesses. Drug treatment to suppress the virus has expanded. One result has been fewer babies born infected by their mothers. Still, the report says 10 million people are waiting for treatment. UNAIDS officials also say not enough is being spent for prevention. They say prevention efforts are responsible for much of the progress. More and more young people say they are following safer practices. Surveys find greater use of condoms, and people in many countries say they have fewer sexual partners. World Health Organization Chief Margaret Chan called this year's AIDS report encouraging. But she noted that the populations most at risk are also those who have the least access to services. These populations include sex workers, drug users, and homosexual men. In other health news, a new study has found that one in every 100 deaths in the world is caused by other people smoking. Researchers found that more than 600,000 non-smokers died in 2004. They say the deaths were from diseases and infections caused by secondhand smoke, also known as passive smoking. The study in the journal Lancet says 165,000 of those tobacco victims were children. For VOA Special English, I'm Alex Villarreal.